I will drive you to the point of death.
Yes, Father!
$2,563 for Father.
Yay!
David. David, the less you sleep, the stronger you'll become. Father doesn't sleep for days at a time. Now let's hear the chant.
Bring in the money. Stay awake. Smash out Satan.
We can't hear you.
Bring in the money. Stay awake. Smash out Satan.
Louder.
Bring in the money. Stay awake. Smash out Satan. Bring in the money. Stay awake. Smash out Satan. Bring in the money. Stay awake. Smash out Satan. Bring in the money. Stay awake. Smash out Satan. Bring in the money. Stay awake. Smash out Satan. Bring in the money. Stay awake. Smash out Satan. Bring in the money. Stay awake. Smash out Satan.
What is this? Oh, come on, give me a break. Come on, I wear this because, you know, I wear it because, you know, it's not gaudy. And besides, let's face it, people don't punch nuns, okay? I may look tough, but I need protection. Fortunately, we've got a guy in the back there. There he is, big guy. Oh, he's big, yeah. Saw me eat a car earlier tonight. Yeah, a moving car. Car just went by, you know, he took a bite out of the fender. Hey, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. There's a guy sitting here holding a bicycle wheel. Seriously, look. Hey, hey, fella, having a big time? I mean, there's a guy sitting here, not laughing. Not laughing, holding a bicycle. If that's all they sold you, you got ripped off. I mean, I'm no expert on bikes or anything, but isn't there supposed to be like a big metal part? You know, with another wheel, maybe? No doubt about it, no laughs are coming from him. Not one laugh is coming from him. I know what it is. You don't buy the story about the nun's outfit, right? You think I'm wearing this because I need cheap laughs. Is that what it is? I don't need this for cheap laughs. You don't want to know what I think of cheap laughs? I'll show you what I think of cheap laughs. Out there think I'm hysterically funny. You sit there like cold borscht. Best friends are supposed to laugh, okay? Even when I stink up the joint, which I didn't tonight.
Well, this friend's got something really important to tell you. There's a run in your carrot.
What? What's the matter, David? Sarah moving out again?
How's Mr. Stone treating
you? Wait a minute, David, really, I'm really trying to be serious with you.
I'm sorry. I keep forgetting you're in your business suit.
Look, can I tell you something, please? I think that you should let Sarah go, because the only time you're ever really nuts about her is when she's leaving. Otherwise, you don't talk
about
her. No,
look, let's forget about it, okay?
No, I don't want to forget about it. I'm trying to tell you something. I think you should relax. I think you should take it easy. Why don't you see somebody else? Somebody nice. Well, Jesus Christ, it's not exactly as if you've been in park lately. You know? What about, what's her name? Erica, when was she? 2 weeks ago?
That wasn't my fault. I mean, look at the profile.
Get out of here. Well, what the hell were you going to go to California for if it wasn't for that?
To see Carl.
Uh-huh. And?
Relax a bit.
To take it easy, to relax a bit. Well, good. Why don't you go and relax a bit?
Okay.
Yeah. And while you're at it, why don't you go give Carl my worst, will you? I mean my best, of course. Listen, I want to tell you something. Listen to me, okay? Please. I love you, and I love Sarah, but individually. David, together, I think you're a mess. You know?
Like a bird on a wire, like a drunk in a midnight choir, I have tried in my way to be free. like a worm on a hook, like a night in some old-fashioned book. I have saved all my rivers for thee. If I have been untrue,
KLC,
I hope you know it was never to you.
It's David.
Much about you.
Oh, yeah? Like what, what has he told you about me?
Oh, everything he said was wonderful.
Oh, I'm sorry, David. I could not tell a lie. What? What?
Saves the dying carpus. You'll see why in a minute.
David? Hi.
Hello.
I'm Ruthie. Carl's told me so much about you. Come on, you must be Star. Come on. Well, what do you think?
What is it?
We're called the Young Pioneer Community Center. We're sort of a cooperative, except we're not. You see, it's a whole new concept. We run legal aid centers and health clinics and daycare centers and free food giveaways and old folks' homes. Isn't that great?
Who pays?
Well, we have all sorts of companies to deal with that. We are 100%, 100% self-supporting.
All in 7 years. Isn't that fantastic?
So why the big secret?
Oh, I wanted you to see it so you'd believe it.
And how many years can some people exist before they're allowed to be free? Yes, and how many times can a man turn his head and pretend that he just doesn't see? Oh, the answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
Dave, I'm really sorry. I have to fill in for someone up at the camp. Their mother died, and I can't refuse. Hey, wait a minute. Why don't you come along?
Yeah, David, why not? It'll be fun. Come
just
on.
For the
you'll
weekend?
Love it. You'll come on. Why not?
Come on, David.
We'll take off.
Sure.
Come on.
To the country, to the big city. Come on. It's beautiful.
Hey! Terrific.
You're marching in, oh, when the saints. Good morning, brothers. How is everybody?
Wake up, come on. Wake up, David. Good morning, welcome to California. Yeah, I know, the sun's been up for hours. Come on, let's go.
Come on.
Calm. He has to go into town. Hi, I'm Dan.
I'm Greg. Nice to meet you. Carl told me all about you. You're going to have a great day. Come on, let's go.
Beautiful.
How you finding it so far?
Fine, fine.
Yeah, it's great, huh?
Yeah.
So how long you known Carl?
A while.
Yeah? You grew up together or something?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a great guy, huh?
Oh, thanks.
Sure. Want toothbrush?
No, thanks.
So, what brought you to California?
What happened? You run out of wood?
Huh? Well, what brought you to California?
Exercise time,
old boy! Come on! Let's go, David! Oh, okay, but you gotta hurry or we're gonna miss the best part. You see, we got this terrific new way of doing them. Come on, or we really are gonna miss the best part. Come on.
Okay, everybody, how about a chooch?
Yeah!
Okay, we're only new people. The chooch is like our private cheer. Are we ready?
Yeah.
And...
each other first. We'll go round in a circle and everybody share a little bit about themselves. I am Ruthie, of course, and I'm a teacher from Topeka. I've been with the family for 5 years, and they have been the greatest 5 years of my life. Okay? Anybody like to start? Greg.
Okay. Let me see. I'm originally from New Hampshire. And I'm a financial analyst. And before I came here 5 weeks ago, my one ambition in life was to make money. I got my MBA at Harvard, and I went to Wall Street, and I figured I'd make my first million by the time I was old, 29, 30. And I would have done it too, but one day I discovered that I was being asked to, they wanted me to lie to my best friend about the financials of this company that we were trying to unload on a pension fund that he was handling. He should have checked. But he didn't. I guess he trusted me or something.
was fired.
Galileo, you ought to be in jail.
They said Columbus was crazy.
You're off. You're not, Chris.
They said Orville Wright was mad. Even his own mother thought he was a little weird.
You're a bird brain, Orv, my boy.
But today, man has walked on the moon. So why is the idea of building an ideal world so crazy?
Because it is, that's all.
That's right. Yeah. Look, here at Liberty City, we're trying to build a community on ideals, not just feelings. Oh, it takes discipline at first. The same kind of discipline a musician needs. First, he has to learn to play the scales. Boring.
This is really interesting. It's the part I was telling you
but
about.
That's how he develops true freedom. Which is great.
How do you like it so far?
I don't know. I'll have to think about it.
Oh, well, what parts do you want to think about?
Well, nothing, really. I just want to go for a walk.
Oh, great. Sure is a nice day for a walk, isn't it?
I'd like to go for a walk alone.
Oh. Sure. I just thought you might like some company, that's all.
Yeah. Well, No, okay.
David? David? We haven't had a chance to meet you yet.
It's hard to take someone's hand just because they want to take yours. We're only interested in doing our own thing, Daddy-o. We're selfish. We're negative. We won't listen. We owe it to ourselves to be objective. But we've been so well trained. We don't believe anything anymore. We stunt ourselves. We don't grow. Growth comes only through a conscientious common base. God speaks through our conscience. Our relationship to God should be like that of a child to his father. Confucius says, sincerity is the way of heaven. Come on, Mama. Come on, baby.
Come on. Come on. I mean, what is this? A religion of some kind? Half of Dr. Drone's lecture this morning was about God. I half expected the friggin' Holy Ghost to come wandering in.
It's just a concept. I'm trying to synthesize all the disciplines. Science, religion, history, philosophy, art.
What is the story on sex here?
We're trying to learn some real respect for women. So we can enjoy them more.
I thought you had the enjoying part figured out by the time you were six.
Yeah. So did I.
No.
So there's no way you can get out of here before Monday, eh?
No, no, no. I promised.
Come on. Give it a break.
Look at it as a two-day experiment.
You might learn something.
Come. Screw off. But thanks for sharing.
You're welcome.
You got a light?
No, I don't smoke anymore.
I mean, the intensity is incredible. There's something right out of...
Skinner.
Yeah, Skinner. Man, why are you always wrapping yourself up in numbers like this?
So you can always come and tell me what a crock it is.
Monday, huh? Okay, Monday. I'll give you my analysis on the way to Big Sur.
Uh-huh.
Meanwhile,
I'm starving.
She appeals to you.
Yes. Yes, starving.
Take her with us some food. Come on. I didn't get a chance to tell you last night. I'm really sorry about Sarah.
Yeah, well, yeah. Life, death, etc.
Or grief, despair. So anyway, you crashed the dance in the front of Ethan's.
Yeah, I did.
No, here, David, you take mine. We weren't sure if you were coming back.
No, thanks.
Oh, I insist. I've been having such a great time, I'm not hungry. I insist, David.
Thank you.
David, you haven't said a word about yourself yet. And we are dying to know something about you.
Yeah, yes, come on, David, share something with it.
Well, I'm a teacher, like Ruthie.
We're gonna kill them so they know how much we love them. We're gonna bomb them into the ground. What are we gonna do?
Bomb with love! 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 Bomb with love!
Ours is the most violent century in all history. We strive for harmony and find conflict. We search for love and find anger. St. Paul cried, I can will what is right, but I cannot do it. Pogo said, I have found the enemy. And he's us. We've turned love into lust, freedom into license. We roam from bed to bed, desperate for something of lasting value. Anything.
I slept with just about every guy who wanted to. Some of them were nice. A lot of them were. But I didn't love them. And they didn't love me. I said no more. I stopped going out. I just asked myself, what else is there? We can't do it alone, Bonnie. We need support. We all need support.
Thank you.
Oh. Oh, I never said that before. Oh, it feels good.
Paul, you're wonderful!
Dr. Joy. In the fullness of creation, let us all delight. Like a towering redwood forest, human outcome forth.
Like the purest mountain waters, come the loyal wife.
Joining hands, they clear the land, laughing, dancing free.
They shall be a mighty people in this blessed land.
Hey, hey, wonderful vision, vision of the joy.
In the fullness of creation, let us all delight.
Jesus was not meant to die. He failed. Because the people of his time wouldn't listen to him. God chose him as the champion of his age, just as he chose Buddha, Confucius, and Muhammad. What would we do with this crazy man, Jesus, today? Kill him all over again? And for what? What was his message? So simple.
Tell you how much I loved him. He seemed so wise. So magical. Then he died.
When my grandfather died, the family, everything, became unglued. That feeling we all had, that we shared when he was alive. Well, it just didn't happen anymore. Even in my most personal relationships. With women. Yesterday, when Nicole and Bonnie were talking, I kept thinking, I'm one of those guys they're talking about. Lay and run. Up till now, I've been very defensive, and I realize that. But I do want to say something.
Once was lost, but now
Big gobs of negativity in your hair. Oh, and it's on your arms. Look at it. Oh, get it off. Oh, it's awful. Oh, damn it. Oh, some on me.
And they were right. The early pioneers were nuts to think that they could cross the Rocky Mountains. Imagine, the Rocky Mountains. They must have been crazy. Well, there's a new kind of craziness around. It's called hope. And it's going to change the world. We are the chosen generation. We must stop.
David! 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 David!
I told you it would be an incredible experience. You have to be strong, David.
Carl, I really got to talk to you.
No, we will. Come on. This is the last lecture.
Oh, no,
come
on, Carl, no.
Come on. This is the last lecture. And then you can take the bus.
Aren't you coming with me?
No. My place is here.
Carl, I really gotta talk to you.
I know. Davy, we will. There'll be plenty of time for that. Plenty of time for that. Afterward.
Come on.
I'll be with you. I'll be with you.
Be strong, David. You're still so young. Don't worry. I'll be right here with you.
Management fees, $3,600.
He says his name is David Capel.
Car delivery, 24. Advertising, bank charge.
Mr. Stone, I'm going to have to take this, okay? Okay. I'll be right back. Sorry. Thanks a lot. Davey.
Hi, what's up? You lose track of time out there?
No. Look, I'm not coming home right away.
Uh-huh. What's her name?
It's more important than that, Larry. It's the greatest thing that's ever happened to me.
Yeah? Like what?
I can't describe it, really. Not really. You have to experience it to know what I mean.
Anyway, I'll be staying here for a while. And
you, David, how long are you talking about?
I'm not sure. Look, I gotta run now. I'll phone you in a few weeks.
David, have you told your folks about this?
They're in Florida, and I lost their number. Could you, no. I'll call them when they get back. I gotta go now. Bye.
You're gonna make a wonderful heavenly child, David.
Did he say where he was calling from?
No. No, he didn't.
In the
children bow. Heavenly children bow. Heavenly children bow.
Would you like to buy some flowers? They're fresh cut.
No, thanks.
For your wife? Well, your girlfriend. It's for a good cause. We're a Christian group raising money for a drug rehabilitation center.
Okay, how much?
$2 each, $20 for a dozen.
Make it the dozen.
Thank you, sir. Have a nice day.
Have we got anything to do with the drug program center?
Not yet.
You lied to that man, Patrick.
I brought in $20 for Father.
But it's lying.
David, it's only Satan's money we're taking, right?
Yeah.
And since Satan cheated to get it, it's our mission to get it back, however we have to.
But Patrick.
David, you've got to get rid of your old concepts. Now, say that man was dying in a fire. Wouldn't you do anything you had to save him, even lie?
Sure.
Well, he is dying. Spiritually, he is dying. But we just sold him a ticket to heaven. Someday he'll thank us. Come on. It's up to you. Do you want to move forward to perfection or go back to what you were?
I want to move forward.
Then you know you have to follow Father's desires.
I'm trying to, Patrick. I'm trying.
But what happens when you doubt Father? You let Satan in, don't you? A questioning mind is Satan's mind, David.
Yes, Patrick.
Hold tight. Heavenly Father, help us and help me to bring David closer to you. Help him to smash out doubt and follow center and to become one with you, Father, in love. We pray in the name of our true parents. Amen. So give us the chant.
Glory to heaven. Peace on earth. Bring in the money.
Great. So let's bring in the money.
Okay.
Hey! Up here. You go to the other side. Hi, would you like to buy some...
Excuse me, would you like to buy some flowers? We're a Christian group trying to raise money for a drug rehabilitation program. Would you like to buy some flowers?
Good morning, everybody!
I told you to crawl on your belly in the streets, would you do that?
Yes, Father!
If I told you you can't eat, you can't sleep, you can't stop running for God, would you do that?
Yes, Father!
That you all must be bonkers.
Yes, Father!
Bonkers for God!
Nicole's group. You come with me, David. David, what's more important, a bowl of stew or the heavenly kingdom? Here. Let's give this to Boyd. Boyd, it's for you. Come on. And if they really press, tell them you'll be home soon. We can't upset them. Can we?
No.
No.
Hello?
Dad!
Davy! Hey! Listen, what the hell's going on down there? How come all of a sudden you can't be reached?
I'm sorry, Dad. I've been out of town working day and night on a project.
You're too busy to phone your own mother?
No, Ma. I meant to call, honest.
So when do we see you?
Soon, Ma, soon.
How soon is soon?
Maybe in 3-4 weeks, okay? I've been running all over the place, setting up this special cool school for disturbed kids. And
listen, what's this?
Pioneer Communist something that you're with.
Young Pioneer Community Center, Dad. It's just what it sounds like.
How are you keeping?
I feel terrific.
Thank you so, so very, very much, Heavenly Father, for protecting David on the phone. We pray in the name of our true parents.
I have to share. Greg is being possessed.
Patrick, find him. Tell Ruthie, have Nicole love bomb and make sure that he's on the bus to Liberty City tonight. Patrick, I knew he wasn't ready.
Good health. Enjoy it.
Foster. In charge.
Well, he's on stage.
Please, I gotta talk to him. He's my friend, please.
Okay, would you hold on 1 minute, okay? Hold on.
Harry!
Hurry, please, hurry. Hurry, please, hurry.
Harry! It's really important.
Hurry, please, hurry.
I think your party will be with you in a moment, sir.
Hang up, David.
Harry!
That's right. I got a phone call. Can you believe it? It's like probably from a zucchini, right? Thank you very much. It's better be good, honey. It's better be real good.
How did you find me?
We wouldn't leave you alone. Come with me. I'll help you.
Young people's community, whatever it's called. So they say, no, David's not even in San Francisco. They say he's away on some special mission of some kind, right? They say, can't possibly be David who called me.
Then what makes you so sure it was him?
Oh, come on, Morley, I don't know anybody else in San Francisco. It's got to be David. Morley, would you please listen to me? I'm trying to tell you something. I think that David is involved in some kind of religious cult.
What are you talking about?
You heard me.
Do you know that for sure?
Well, I called the San Francisco cops, all right?
And?
And they say there's nothing they can do about it. It's got something to do with a Supreme Court decision.
How many years have I been trying to get him into a synagogue, and now you tell me that just like that, somebody's got him worshiping some messiah from Jakarta? Davey's a goddamn atheist, for Christ's sake.
Morley. I know I can't expect to find the job here when I get back, Mr. Stone, but I just have to go.
Take my sister a dozen bagels, will you?
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
Passengers arriving on Air Canada flight 757, connecting to Honolulu.
Excuse me, sir. I'd like to show you this book.
Bald.
Pardon?
Bald. Bald's a book I've been reading. It's terrific. No pictures in it, but, you know, you can use your imagination. You know, right? Let's have it for $1.95. No, let's have it for free.
Oh, excuse me, sir. I'd like to show you this, this book here.
Hi, Larry.
David.
Larry, I'm Ingrid. This is Patrick.
Hi. David, are you okay?
I'm fine. It's good to see you.
Health clinics, homes for the aged, daycare centers. We've grown so fast. It's a maze. You should come have a look. We could use a good accountant.
David, what happened to your arm?
Just some poison ivy.
Have you seen a doctor about that?
I'm sitting right next to him.
Well?
Well, it's healing very quickly, really. It's best not to cover it up at this stage. David's a model patient.
You really owe it to yourself, Larry, to come
Excuse
and have
me
a look around.
Just a second, please. David, why don't you come home with me for just a few days? Everybody's really worried.
Excuse us.
Wait a minute. Where are you going?
David has an important appointment with the State Health Department today about the school I was telling you about.
David, I came 4,000 miles to see you.
I'm sorry, Larry. I'd like to stay. I really would, but...
David?
I'm sorry. It's really very important. He'll be at the house tonight for supper. You come by then, you can talk all you want. See you then. Bye-bye.
Wait a minute. David?
Your check, sir.
Oh, David on the mountain, and we are moving on.
Isn't this great? Oh,
are you sure that he is up there?
That's what he said.
Over the hills and everywhere. Come, tell it on the mountain, and we are moving on. Go tell it on the mountain.
No, ma'am. It really was a 10 you gave me, you see?
Ruthie said he sang a filthy song all the way up on the bus last night.
Yeah, well, that's Larry.
Yeah, I found the lecture fascinating. It was,
well, I was moved. Reminded me of the writings of Besant Singh Pradhu.
But I don't like to be touched.
But I can't see your eyes.
Well, it was better that way. You've heard of Besant Singh Pradhu?
No.
You look like you've heard of Besant Singh Pradhu. He was a very famous Indian holy man. And he wrote the Amko Koram. Also, he wrote about taking people's property without permission, but it wasn't important. But he wrote after fasting for a long time, which was incredibly difficult for him because he was very fat and he liked his food. He used to be a head waiter.
I mean, all he wants, Lisa, is for someone to laugh at his terrible jokes.
Okay. I'll call Ruthie again. But you better pray for him.
Please, Heavenly Father, help Larry.
David told me you're a wonderful comic.
Oh, yeah, he said that? Where is he, anyway?
Oh, I told you he'll be back soon. He will. I'm sure he'd love to see your act again. Danny!
Lisa!
David!
Heavenly children, Satan will do anything to destroy this great work. He'll beat us, torture us. He'll send our own parents to kidnap us. But Lisa, we'll not let Satan in. Satan always forgets something. Ballpoint pen? A light bulb? A coat hanger? A nail? And Lisa knows. A cross. For hospital. Down. For death.
Hi. My name is Larry. I'm so happy to be here.
I haven't slept in 3 days, but I don't care. Well, good night. Okay. No jokes. Very seriously. All kidding aside, I've been here for a little while now. And I've noticed what you people have done, and you're amazing.
May I leave now?
Hey, am I kidding? I mean, leave this place? Hey, where else can you get up in the morning while it's still dark and have a nice cup of cold gruel? And just sort of sit around and talk about God all day long. That's my idea of a big time. That's fun for me. That's good. I mean, what else is there in life, right? Except maybe, you know, donating all your worldly goods to some project you've never heard of. Do you think that's a good idea? If you think that's a good idea, I got some swampland in Florida you'd be interested in. Hey, if you think I've got a lousy sense of humor, look at him. He is laughing. Hey, fella, having a big time? No, hey, I'm not going to argue with him. I mean, he's big, right? I saw him eat a car earlier tonight. No, wait a minute, a moving car. The car just sort of went by, took a bite out of it. I don't know. Oh. He's not laughing now.
That was really terrific.
Oh, really? Yeah. You like it?
Yeah, you're
thank
great.
You. Thank you.
Great show, Larry. Really good.
Thanks a lot.
First rule, man. Don't fucking cooperate.
Lights out. Yay, Larry! Yay, Larry! Yay, Larry! Bomb with love! Bomb with love! Ace the ball! Ace the ball! Bomb with love! 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 Bomb with love!
I saw Satan in the eyes of my father. Victory to father!
Regurgitate like that since the bicentennial celebration. The whole town, a loaf of glory, wound up on his knees in a communal hall.
What?
There's a juice punch that done it. There's a liver shriveler, boy. Blend of two kinds of juice and a slice of lime and a tinge of white lightning, you know, just a tinge.
Just, yeah.
But the best part was that 10 pounds of fine ground catfish eyes.
Catfish?
I'm sorry. So after a lot of thinking and drinking, I decided a little gainful employment was in order.
Wait a minute. Do I know you?
Oh, man, I'm trying to rectify that. You want a cigarette?
No, I don't. Thanks.
So anyway, I started farming. You know those real tall bushes that smell so good when you smoke them?
Oh, man, that was the best damn homegrown ever blew your socks off. Tons of it. But unfortunately, old Jack Murphy wasn't too impressed, so I was obliged to spend 9 months at his place.
Who's Jack Murphy?
Who's Jack Murphy? Well, he's the sheriff of Loafer's Glory. Oh. Loafer's Glory, that's my hometown. Oh, anyway, Jack arranged this, so I got to spend most of my time in solitary. I kept myself sane by counting to 131 and back.
Why 131?
Why not?
Oh, God. It must be something they put in the food.
Oh, man, it's what they don't put in it. Protein. That and all the jumping and chanting and spacing out. After a while, your wiring blows. Women stop getting their period. Guys get cheeks as smooth as the inside of Sarah Elizabeth Murphy's left eye.
What were you doing in there?
Now, that's private.
What were you doing in the camp?
Well, it's my sister, man. She's in one of these loony groups, when I find out which one. What about you?
Wait, did you see what I see?
All right. That's it.
Come to me.
That's it.
Come to me.
We're out of here now.
Come on.
Why me?
You know.
I just can't believe it.
Sarah. Sarah. If I hadn't been there myself.
I'm seeing somebody else now. What's he gonna think?
The worst.
But why Sarah? If she hadn't left him in the first place, he'd still be here.
Essie, she's the bait.
You think I never watch TV? Why not his mother?
Well, actually, we would like you to come too, Essie. You see, we need somebody who can sweet-talk them into taking David to a... well, to a place where we can grab him. You think you can do that?
Can Frank Sinatra sing?
You realize that we can't let on that you're coming because they'd smell a rat.
His own mother, a rat?
Oh, it's worse than that, Essie. You're Satan. We're all Satan.
I know I can't count on the job being here when I get back, Mr. Stone, but we've been waiting 3 months for this chance and...
Can't you go to jail for that?
For 14 years.
Ex?
Where do you live?
Oh.
Purpose of your visit?
Business.
Will you be leaving anything in the United States?
That's my sister.
Have a nice visit.
Thank you.
Next. Where do you live?
Toronto.
Purpose of your visit?
To get a little sun.
It's gonna work.
What do you think, Mr. Stone? What do you say? Okay. What do you say then, huh?
Looks good to me.
Yeah, it looks good. Huh? Come on, what do you think? What do you think? It's good. Come on.
Yes.
It's gonna work. It's gonna work.
I hope we get it right the first time.
Sarah, it's good to see you.
There's Sarah.
Mom, what are you doing here?
Oh, David. Oh, David. Oh. What do you mean, what am I doing here? Try hello or how are you, Mother? Listen, who could phone you?
Oh, they're blowing a gasket.
Come on, Essie. Come on, Essie. The Empire State Building if you wanted to.
What's wrong with you? In these clothes, your mother does not go to dinner. How long can it take? Is there a fire?
A quick shower, I'll change, and then we'll go. So, tell me all about this new school my David is starting.
Looks like she did it.
Throw it away.
All right.
Yeah.
We've got 2 minutes.
Almost got it in.
What?
Okay, I see it. You went in the wrong goddamn parking spot.
What are you doing? Get in there and kidnap him.
Yes, sir.
Sorry, Francis, but he ain't talking. Father got his tongue.
Bastard.
In here.
David? David.
Hey, come on. Let's start clearing this place out.
Please.
David. All we want to do is just talk to you. At least eat something, schmuck.
What?
Drink, eat, relax, nothing. Nothing happened.
What? This is Oakland, man.
Oh, I get it, Eric. You become immune to acts of violence.
Hello?
Morley?
Look, I can't talk now. It seems we're under arrest.
What?
Don't worry about us.
And don't call here again. This thing may be bugged. Just do what you have to do. That's an order.
Christ. Would you call that guy again, please? They've been arrested. Morley and Esther have been arrested, David. God damn it, your own parents have been arrested.
Mom and Dad, they...
If you let me go, we won't press charges.
I mean, we won't press the charges. Jerry. Hey, Jerry. Hey, Jerry. Hey.
Filter.
The hell is that?
It means to charm. That's a seven-letter word and two triple word scores. That'd be... that's 113 points.
I can add.
It's a tall dude.
Yeah, is it him?
I never met the fella.
Well, if it's the cops, they're coming in anyway, right?
If it's one of them loonies, he ain't.
Link's drunk.
Where is he?
Where is he?
What's the matter, David? If you're such a loving person, why can't you love me? Love even Satan. Aren't you supposed to love everybody?
You're a zombie, David. Your eyes are vacant. You're almost dead, man. But that's good. I mean, that's a relief. If you look normal like Brother Carl or Sister Ingrid, You would be dead. So cheer up. I'm here. I'm here to give you a soul injection, a life transfusion. We'll be here as long as it takes. Day, week, month, year, I don't care. I've got the time. How about some lunch?
I know that he's a little heavy. David, but really, he's supposed to be okay.
You know, this is really nuts. I mean, like, all our pictures are in the paper. We're stuck in the house. We can't get out. The cops are closing in. It's really ridiculous.
We'll do it my way, or not at all. Is that clear? Before I can make him think, I have to make him talk. Before I can make him talk, I have to make him feel something. And fear is primal.
You can drink here, but not in there. Liquor offends him. Let's respect that. I want him to get lots of sleep. I want him to get lots of protein food. I want to hear everything that's happened to him in the last 12 months.
He won't eat.
He'll eat. And right now, you better get that light fixture out of his room.
You think he can reach that?
If he wants to, he will. And he'll want to pretty soon.
David?
It's really good to see you again. How you doing? Oh, do you mind? Come on, David, talk to me. I haven't seen you for ages.
So they put me back in the camp, and for about a week they love-bombed me. But it didn't work anymore. One day I just ran. They chased me all the way home to New Hampshire. But my mother read about these people that help, and they hid me out. Come on, David, talk to me. I came all the way here just to see you.
You're here to tempt me, Greg.
No, David. I just came to talk with you. I'm your friend.
You've come to tempt me, Greg.
Come on, David, you don't really believe that Spumoni? That all the people you really love and trust are just Satan's tools? Hey, come on.
I believe Father's word.
You ever read it, David? That's okay. No one else has either. They made you feel guilty, though, for wanting to take the time to read it, didn't they? Didn't they, David? But what could be more important than Father's word? Come on, David. Think. Think!
Maybe. Maybe they're just worried. You'll find it's all nonsense.
It's divinely inspired.
A book written by a businessman?
He's the Messiah.
Who says?
Jesus prophesied it.
Mrs. Foster, have we a Bible in this house?
Isaiah prophesied it.
Now, where was it Jesus said that Father was the new Messiah?
I don't know. I've never read it. Only Father can interpret its meaning.
All right. Well, maybe we should try something easier. I mean, something even you and I can understand. Okay, how about... In those days, the sun shall be darkened. The moon shall not give her light. The stars of heaven shall fall, and the powers that are in heaven shall be shaken. And then shall they see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory, and every man will see him.
Jesus had to put it that way, or all sorts of people would claim to be the Messiah.
Jesus was lying then?
No. Jesus said, "These things I have spoken to you as parables." Why don't you read that?
All right. Now maybe we should see how Father explains himself. I think it's page 516. Would you like to read it? How about someone else, then? Sarah. Sarah, would you hand him the book? What's the matter with Sarah? You know Sarah. You lived with her. You loved her, didn't you?
I lusted for her.
Look at her when you say it. Look at her. Come on now, David. It's a lot worse than that, isn't it? You lusted. But she tempted you. Sarah is the daughter of Eve, who slept with the serpent and then seduced Adam. Sarah made you fornicate with her. Sarah defiled you as Eve defiled Adam, right?
Sarah tempted me. She defiled me.
Right! Sex is worse than murder, David. Right?
Yes. Right.
If you want to go home.
That's not why I'm crying, you jerk. I love him. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Just leave. Sorry.
Yeah.
Searching tonight for a black van bearing North Carolina license plates seen leaving the kidnaps. The van is registered to an Eric Wallace of no fixed address, but who is believed to live in the El Cerrito area of Oakland. The 300 members of the Young Pioneer Community Center have also joined the search, pledging themselves to go without sleep until David Capel is...
He's tough, and he's smart. It's like trying to start a Cadillac that's been sitting for 5 years. Shit, the dumb ones are easy.
How long do you think this is going to take? I mean, they're going to be coming in through the door any... Sorry. Sorry, I didn't say anything.
You're right. You can't deprogram him in court. What wouldn't you do for Father? What if he ordered you to kill?
I wouldn't have to necessarily. I could say no.
Bullshit, David!
Father says, I am your mind.
And doesn't he also say that his real mission is the subjugation of the world, and that everybody who opposes him will be punished, and that many, many thousands of people will die? Now, who is going to do the killing? And what happens when you don't obey? Oh, come on, David. Come on, come on, come on. Think, think. If you disobey Father, you disobey God. When you disobey God, you follow Satan, and you are condemned to eternal damnation. Don't you see there's no room in there? For maybe I will, maybe I won't.
But that would mean we're all robots.
David, you lie, you cheat, you swindle. For what?
Well, there's real estate, millions and millions of dollars of it. Office buildings, estates, factories, hotels. There's newspapers in New York, Tokyo, England, travel agencies, restaurants, print shops, carpet cleaning companies, textile plants, tea plants, machine tool, boat building, titanium, stoneware, fish packing plants in California. There's cod, herring, and anchovies, shrimp in Alaska, tuna in Louisiana, lobster in Massachusetts. There's karate schools. There is a jewelry business in France. Now, you sleep in vans, and they feed you almost nothing. But Father seems to live rather well. $1 million estate, 2 swimming pools, a sauna, 50-foot yacht, a custom-made Lincoln Continental. And you know his dinner plates, they're etched in gold. They have to be replaced with new ones every time he eats. That is the Messiah you're running for.
Father is simply restoring what Satan stole from God.
Well, what does God need a munitions plant for, David? Father has a factory where they make M16 rifles, anti-aircraft guns, and grenade launchers. What's that got to do with God?
Liar! Liar! You liar!
A fucking gun factory.
If Father's love isn't unselfish, then whose is?
I don't know, man. You see, I'm not God. And I don't have any answers. All I do know is that Father's is a lie.
If you want to know about unselfish love, take a look around. We're all here only because we love you. Your mother and your father are under arrest because they love you. We're all doing this. We're scared stiff of going to jail because we love you. David, that's love. And if you can't see that, if you can't see that,
Father is the Messiah. That means every person here is evil. We're trying to take you away from him. But if they aren't evil, that means the Father isn't the Messiah, doesn't it? Come on. Listen, only you can make the decision. I know you're terrified at leaving the church.
So was I.
It's all so confusing.